Live and at you, my name is Danilo Ignacio, correspondent host for Gay TV Atlanta. And we've got a great treat coming on next up. We're going to talk to Don Lemon and his book, Transparent. Stay tuned, we got a whole lot more. We are at Outwrite Bookstore out here in Atlanta. Stay tuned. I'm your host, Danilo Ignacio.
Our author tonight is a multiple Emmy Award winning journalist, a former Today Show correspondent, and one of CNN's most well-known and well-respected news anchors. In his memoir, Don Lemon takes readers behind the scenes of journalism, detailing his own struggle to become one of the most prominent African-American men in television news and inside some of the biggest stories of our times. With his clear and compelling storytelling and his rich detail of a journalist, Don Lemon reveals his own painful journey from a little boy who dreamed of broadcasting in segregated Baton Rouge in the early 70s to his current perch at CNN. Oh, and along the way, he announced that he is gay. Never one to stop at the surface of the story, Lemon digs deep, exposing his own history with family secrets and painful revelations, and explains how those painful early experiences shaped his ambitions and gave him the tools of empathy and fearlessness that he brings to his work. In the book, he turns to the news industry itself, taking the stories he's covered, September 11th, the DC snipers, AIDS in Africa, Hurricane Katrina, the death of Michael Jackson, and the election of Barack Obama. Now, when Don finished this book, or as he was writing the book, he couldn't decide whether he was going to come out of the closet in the book. And about that time came the story of Tyler Clementi. Tyler was a young man, a student at Rutgers, who killed himself after it was revealed that he was gay. And that one incident that so many people learned that they really need to come out, and Don Lemon is one of them. So please welcome out to Outwrite, Don Lemon.
I cannot believe this. My friends, hey Reggie and Phil, say hi.
Hello.
These are my running buddies right there. We were can you believe this?
Yes.
I am so thrilled. Every time I've gone, this is my third or fourth book signing, and every time I'm so thrilled that people show up and are interested enough. Seriously, from the bottom of my heart, thank you very much. Thank you. Are you guys? I was worried about the rain. Were you?
Yes.
No. We're going to come anyways?
Yep.
Yes? That's what they make umbrellas for. People on Twitter were like, oh, the rain clouds just moved in Atlanta. I guess I'll have to see Don Lemon another time. But what would you guys like to know about the process? I'll ask questions. Are you going to tell you about the process of writing this book? All right. So listen, I was approached by a publishing company after I did a panel at Morehouse University called Black Men in the Age of Obama. And it's this young guy, he's in his 20s and he's a millionaire, I hate him. And he said, I think you have a book in you. And I went, what? You know, what are you talking about? Am I fat? What's going on? He said, I think you have a book in you. And I said, okay, well. And he said, do you want to write a book? And I said, no, far, it's not time yet. I'm not, you know, I haven't reached the level where I can write a book. So what I realized is that what I was doing to myself was what other people did to me when they didn't want to be bothered. They told me no, right? Yeah. Hey, I'd like to do this project. No. I'd like to go on this story. No. I have an idea. No. And that means that they don't want to be bothered, right? Or they don't find what you find interesting enough to pay enough attention to become absorbed in it or to say yes. So then I realized I was doing to myself what people do to me when they don't want to be bothered. I was telling myself no. And so I said, okay, fine, I'll write your darn, that's not what I said, I'll write the darn book. You can imagine what I said. And so I started writing the book, and it's for HCI, which is a publishing arm of Chicken Soup for the Soul, you know what I'm talking about? Which are great books, they're great books. But I said, I started writing it, oh, you know, I'm always the first one in the office. And I'm like, no, I'm not, I'm always late. I'm on CP time. And then I was like, I'm always the last one to leave. Well, that's true. I'm always the last one to leave, but I'm not always the first one in the office. I'm always the one who has, like, well, pretty much, not always, a lot of the times, the idea that's like, people go, oh my gosh, that's, and you know where that comes from? That comes from being gay. To having that idea where people go, where the hell did that come from? It came from my little creative mind when I had to be a kid and I isolated myself and I would create, you know, friends in my head. I had these two friends when I was a kid called Skeeter and Squirto, and Skeeter was my girlfriend and Squirto was my cousin's girlfriend, and my cousin and I were a month apart, and we would go and we'd get dressed and we'd go on dates and we'd ask him out, and they had this pretend house, which was my grandparents' shit. So anyway, it started, was crazy. But but that's where that sort of creative side came from. So I started writing the book and I said, this isn't what I want to write about. And I was having trouble, And by the way, you guys heard from Ben. Ben is my boyfriend, and he is stuck on the tarmac in LaGuardia in New York, because there's a ground stoppage in Atlanta. But he, I just texted him, and he didn't say anything, so maybe he's in the air somewhere, and he might be here by the end. But I was like, Ben, what am I going to do? And even Reggie, and I'm like, I'm writing a book, and Reggie felt like, what? I'm like, yeah, I'm writing a book. So I started trying to write this book, and it was like, it wasn't interesting. Nothing I wrote was interesting. And so the book collaborator came down, and we went to, what's the place over here on Howe Mill, the breakfast place?
West Egg.
We went to West Egg and met. She was staying in a hotel over there. And I said, this is really too impersonal. I want you to come to my house, and I'm going to cook you breakfast, and I'm going to make you coffee, and I'm going to tell you about my life. So she came over, Ben was there, and we ended up having breakfast, and then she's like, what do you like to do? And I'm like, let's get in the car. We're going to Bloomingdale's. And so, between breakfast and Bloomingdale's, we came up with it. She goes, well, where did you grow up? I said, I grew up in this little town right outside of Baton Rouge. It's West Baton Rouge. It's called Port Allen. And I said, you know, it was right in the shadow of my grandparents had sugarcane trucks and an ice house. And there was a sugarcane, there's a Steens, or one of the sugarcane companies, sugar factories, was right in the shadow of my town. So you could smell them making syrup and taking sugar and making it, taking sugar cane and making it into sugar. So in the summer you could smell that, and you could smell the tar on, it was so hot. You could smell the tar on the roads melting and the tar on the roof melting, and you could smell, like when you got near a river or a lake or whatever, you could smell the fish. I mean, Louisiana is very lush. And she looked at me, her name is Karen, she's in the fort, but she's in the book if you look under the things. And she said, well, why don't you start there? And I went, God, you're brilliant, thank you. So that's what I started writing. I said, Louisiana is a place like this where you can smell the fish and that the tar melts, and that, you know, you could, I could smell the sugar cane, and it had this sort of odor to it. And I started writing that, and then it became cathartic because I started writing about my childhood. And I started writing about my abuser, about being molested as a kid. And as I started writing these things, it became truly cathartic. And I said, this, as I started writing them, and I started reading them back, and I would cry, and Ben would look at me and cry, and then he'd laugh at me and say, you're crazy. And I'd say, I know, but it just felt so good. And then I would go into sort of this depression, like, should I be revealing this information? And I'd read it back again, and I'd say, this is a book that I would want to read. This is a book that would have helped me as a young man. This is a book that would have helped me to overcome that depression and that sadness and that fear that I had about my molester. And so I started writing that, and then I got through the whole thing up until college, and then I said, what am I going to do about this gay thing, right? What am I going to do? If this book is supposed to be inspirational, it's supposed to be about my life, and I'm supposed to be encouraging people, then my own story, I think, is the best example of that, because I had challenges growing up, and I still have challenges. And I said, so in order to encourage people, I need to be truthful. I have been a gay man for as long as I can remember, and I was a gay child before that. And I've been pretty successful at being that person and pretty happy at it. So I said, you know what, I'm going to include it. But I don't want it to be a big revelation. At first I was like, and I have to say that I am gay. And then the collaborator's like, that's really not the kind of person that you are. And I said, you know what, you're right. Because in my personal life, I'm out. You know, every Memorial Day I go to Pensacola with my friends. We don't go to the big parties. We just call ourselves the Fringe Boys because we all rent a house and we just sit in the house and eat. And then go and swim, and then we go to Key West. We've been going to Key West for 2 years. So in my personal life, I've been out. I've lived in Chelsea, but I had never said it.
We've got a lot more at Don Lemon's book signing for his book, Transparent. So stay tuned for more Gay TV on location.
Welcome to The Don. You have just accessed the beautiful experience. This experience will cover courtship, sex, commitment.
You're watching Gay TV Atlanta.